relationship there, it's multidimensional when we know the Lord and he knows us. It's a multidimensional relationship. What are you talking about, preacher? Well, John chapter 10, Jesus says in the 14th verse, he says, we're his sheep. In other words, he knows us like a shepherd knows his sheep. He knows us like that. He knows us. He knows us, and he knows what we need. And because we have this sheep to a shepherd relationship, and he knows us that way, he provides for his sheep. He says, I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Are you praying with me? But the 23rd verse helps us to understand, 23rd Psalms help us to understand more intimately what this relationship between sheep and shepherd is really about. Because the 23rd Psalm tells us, it explains the comprehensive care that Jesus gives to those that he knows as his sheep. He says, the Bible says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In other words, whatever I need, the shepherd provides for me. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. In other words, I don't ever go without my needs being met, because the shepherd is responsible for providing for all of my needs. He's making me to lie down in green pastures. He's leading me beside the still waters. He's restored my soul. Every once in a while, when I get weak and I get beaten down by the world, he picks me up and he strengthens me and restores me. He is like a sheep, a shepherd to a sheep. It's comprehensive care. There's nothing that I need that I can't get in Jesus. He's that kind of shepherd. But I can stay on the shepherd all day. But he's more than just a shepherd to sheep. The Bible says he is a friend to his associates. Are y'all praying with me? Look at John 15. John 15, Jesus calls us his friends. That means he is an associate of ours.
All right.
He's a friend of ours.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible says that Jesus isn't like your friends. He's a friend that sticks closer than a brother will. He's not a sometime friend. He's not a friend who's with you when you do what he wants to do. He's your friend whether you do what he wants or whether he does, whether you don't. He's our friend. He's an associate. But not only is he a friend, it tells us this multidimensional relationship we have with Jesus. In Hebrews chapter 2, verses 11 through 12, tells us that we are his brethren. He's acquainted with us. He's acquainted like a shepherd to sheep. He's acquainted like a friend to associates. But he's also, the Bible tells us in Hebrews, he's like a brother to us.
Right.
Are y'all praying with me? Which means those of us who know him and he knows us, we the Bible says, if we are like brethren, brethren means that we share the same womb.
All right.
Oh, come on now.
Yes, sir.
And you can't get no closer than sharing the same womb. We got twins at our house, praise the Lord. And the twins share the same womb. I don't know if you checked out the womb lately, but it ain't much room in there. Come on, somebody. And the womb is barely big enough for one baby to grow. But when two babies are growing in there, that's some tight quarters. That will hit me in a minute. You can't help but touch another person who's sharing the same womb with you. You it ain't your side of the womb. You stay on your side and I stay on my side like we do. Like twins do in the bed. No. In the womb, you can't help but touch each other. Matter of fact, you have the same source in the womb that supplies all of your needs. Y'all gonna hear me in a minute. And so the Bible says that Jesus is like a brother to us. And a brother implies sharing closeness and sharing the same connection. I'm so grateful that the Lord blessed me when I read this, because it helps me to understand that when Jesus went through trouble, when Jesus went through trial, the Bible says that he went to the Father and he prayed to the Father. When he was on the Calvary's cross, he called to the Father. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He said, Father, I commend my spirit. Oh, y'all will hear me in a minute. Every time he got in trouble, he had to call the source of his strength and power. those who are in relationship with him. And that lets me know that not only am I his friend, and not only am I his sheep, and not only am I in an intimate relationship, but the Bible says that Jesus has taken us and brought us in the family. And because I'm in the family, whatever Jesus is entitled to, I'm also entitled to. Whatever Jesus has is also in my future. Now, for him in a minute. For the Bible says we are heirs with him and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. And so because Jesus made it through, because I'm an heir with him, I'm on my way to get through my problem. Because Jesus conquered, and because I'm an heir with him, I'm more than a conqueror. Because of Jesus Christ, because Jesus had power, I have power in order to make it through my journey. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Grandmother, what do you need to do?
to cheer me up. She said, well, I'm baking a cake, but I can stop and give you a snack. And a snack ought to cheer you up. And the boy said, yeah, grandma, grandma, you got some of the best snacks in the world. Give me a snack, I'm sure that'll cheer me up. She said, well, I'm making this cake, but I'm gonna stop. Give me some oil, I'm gonna give you some cooking oil. He said, grandma, what I'm gonna do with that? That's yuck, I don't know no oil. He said, well, maybe you want some baking soda. I got some baking soda for you. I just mix that up for you and give it to you. He said, but grandma, that baking soda tastes bad. That ain't gonna help me lift my spirit. She said, no, I got some flour there, some raw flour. Let me give you some of this flour. I'm baking the cake, but I'll stop and give you. He said, grandma, I don't want no flour. What am I gonna do with that? Well, I got some eggs for you. Everybody like eggs. He said, here's some raw eggs. He said, grandma, I don't want no raw eggs. That ain't gonna make me happy. She said, what you don't understand is that, yeah, by themselves, they don't do nothing for you. By themselves, flour and oil and raw eggs and baking soda don't do nothing for you. But in the right hands, if you mix all that up together, you come out with a beautiful cake. And I know how much you like cake. And that's my word to you, why as I take my seat, you might not be able to handle what happened last week. In and of itself, you may not be able to deal with the problems in your relationship. In and of themselves, you may not be able to handle the problem in your finances. And you don't know how to make your ends meet. But what I want you to know is that God is good. And He's still in control. And in the right hands, if you put all of that together, when God gets through with you, and all of your ingredients, you come out.
Together, there was a